Hello, for this project I'll be using the following things. The size of the hook will depend on the yarn you're using. So let's get into the video. Start by making a slip knot and then make chains. I don't remember the number of chains I made, but I made chains 1 inch less than the waist length I was making. So I was making a top for waist 25, so I made 24 inches. My tape measure is starting from number 2. That's why it's on 25. For your first row, you're going to yarn over, insert your hook in the third chain, and make a half double crochet. Make half double crochets until you reach the end of your chains. I'm done with my first row, so I'll chain 2. Turn your work. This chain 2 acts like a stitch, so skip the first stitch and go to the next. Make a half double crochet and then continue making half double crochets until you reach the end of the row. I'm almost done with my second row, so I'll continue making half double crochets and ensure you go through the very last stitch. After this, you'll continue making 14 rows of half double crochet and then we'll meet after that. I'm done making 14 rows and at this point, my work is 4 inches. From here, we'll join the two ends. So, insert your hook on one end and then insert it on the loop on the other side and then pull the loop through. Make 2 chains. In the previous row, we were moving towards this side, so now you'll turn your work and make a half double crochet in the second stitch from your chain 2. Continue making half double crochets until you reach the end of that row. So I'm almost done with that row. Okay, so now I'm going to make the last half double crochet, then insert my hook in the chain 2, yarn over and make a slip stitch. Next row, chain 2, turn your work, and then from here we're going to make increases. So you're going to make half double crochet in the very first stitch and then continue making half double crochets. We're going to make 4 increases on each row of increase. So that's my first increase. I'm almost in the middle of my front part. I made my first increase when we were starting the row, so I'm going to make the second increase. So make 2 half double crochets in the same stitch and continue making half double crochets. I'm making my third increase, so make two half double crochets in the same space. You'll make another increase and then we'll meet at the end of the row. Another thing, don't make the increases at the same point on each row of increase. So when you're increasing again, don't put the increase at the same point you did in the previous row. I'm done with that row, so you're going to slip stitch, insert your hook in the chain 2 that you made, and then make a slip stitch. Okay, so now chain 2, make 2 chains, turn your work, and then you're going to make a half double crochet in the very first space because you're making an increase. And then after that, there will be no increase throughout that row. So what you'll be doing, you'll be making an increase in one row, and then the next row, there will be no increase, and that will be the pattern. So a row of increase will be followed by a row of no increase until you reach your desired length. I'm almost done with this row, so now I'll make one more half double crochet and then make a slip stitch, insert your hook in the chain 2 and then make a slip stitch. I made 12 more rows and this is what I have at this point. So next you will divide your work into two parts. So count the number of stitches you're having and then divide your work into two. After that, choose the front side and divide the front side into two. I used a different color of yarn to mark my work and this is what you should be having. So for the measurements, the length is almost 6.5 and then the bust part is 14 inches but it can stretch to 16. From here, we will do a different thing. So remove your stitch marker and then you're going to make slip stitches. So make a slip stitch in the next space. And then make one more slip stitch. Next, make 2 chains and then you'll make half double crochets until you reach your middle stitch marker. When you reach your middle stitch marker, you're going to remove the stitch marker and then make a half double crochet in that space. After that, return the stitch marker. Continue making half double crochets until you reach the other stitch marker. Make one more half double crochet and then leave the remaining 2 stitches. So when we started this row, we made 2 slip stitches And then when you're ending, you'll also leave the two spaces. Okay, so now chain two. Turn your work. And then make half double crochets. Skip the first space, go to the next, and make a half double crochet. Continue making half double crochets until you reach the middle stitch mark. Okay, so now I'm almost at the middle stitch marker. And you will make a half double crochet in the space where you are having that stitch mark. So next, make two chains, turn your work. The two chains will act as a stitch. So yarn over, insert your hook in the second space. Yarn over, pull your hook through, you'll have three loops. Insert your hook in the next space. Yarn over, pull your hook through, you'll have four loops. Yarn over and pull your hook through the four loops. From here, you'll continue making half double crochets until you reach the other stitch mark. When you reach the end of that row, you will make another decrease. Chain two, turn your work, and then you'll make another decrease. When you reach the other end, make another decrease. So we'll be making decreases on every row. I made 8 more rows, and this is what I have. So make the same thing on the other side. The reason why we were dividing the front part into two is to make that V-shape. So if you don't want that, you can get rid of it. Next, you're going to work on the back part, so make a slip knot. Insert your hook in the third space from the stitch marker, and then insert it in the slip knot. Pull it through that stitch, and then make a chain. Make another chain, and then you'll make a half double crochet in the second stitch from your chain two. Continue making half double crochets until you reach the other end. I'm almost done with this row, so at this point I'm remaining with 3 stitches. So I'll make one half double crochet in one stitch and leave the two. Make two chains, turn your work. And then you're going to make a decrease. Continue making half double crochets until you reach the other end. I'm at the end of the row and I'm going to make another decrease. So I'm having 2 stitches. So instead of making 2 more half double crochets, I'll only make 1, and that will count as a decrease. So from here, you're going to make more rows of decreases. You decrease on both sides until you reach the same length as the front side. Okay, so this is what I'm having. And next, you're going to make the straps. onto the strap, we're going to make slip stitches. So make a slip stitch in the next stitch and make one more in the next stitch. Okay, so now make chains. I made 67 chains. And then you're going to join your chains to the other side, the front side. So you leave the first two stitches and join your strap to the third stitch. So insert your hook in the third stitch, yarn over and make a slip stitch. Okay, so now turn your work and make slip stitches in the two stitches you left. Turn your work and you're going to make half double crochets along the chains. Okay, so now you're going to join using a slip stitch. Next, you're going to chain two and you're going to start making the arm and turn your work and continue making half double crochets. In this row, we're going to make increases. So you're going to make 12 half double crochets. And then after making 12 half double crochets, you will start making your increases. So you're going to make 2 half double crochets in one stitch. So make increases until you're left with 12 stitches. I'm left with 12 stitches and I'm not going to make any increase on the 12 stitches. Once you're done with the strap part, you'll continue making half double crochets under the arm and you'll be making 2 half double crochets on each stitch. So just find somewhere to insert your hook and make a half double crochet. When you reach the end of that row, you will join your work using a slip stitch. So insert your hook in the chain 2 and make a slip stitch. Chain 2, turn your work and continue making rows of half double crochet. And from this point, there will be no increase. So make 12 more rows and then we'll meet at the end of your 12 rows. I'm done with the 12 rows, and this is what my work looks like at this point. I already made one side of the arm, so I'll show you how I did that. So I'll be using a sewing needle. You can use a darning needle. So I'll be inserting my needle in and out of my stitches. Skip the first row and go to the previous row. So you'll be inserting your hook under and over your stitches until you reach where you started. So I'm done. I removed the needle. Now you're going to pull the yarn. Try and push the ruffles towards the shoulders and leave the underarm without ruffles. Next, we'll be sewing the ruffles in place. So you can decide to cut the yarn you used to make the ruffles after you're done, or leave it. When sewing, ensure that your needle doesn't appear on the other side, on the right side. When you reach the ruffles, you're going to hold them together and then you're going to pass your needle through the ruffle twice. Go ahead and sew the rest of the ruffles, and then if you don't like this technique, you can start decreasing when you reach that point and use the other decreasing technique. I'm done putting the arm into place. So next I'm going to weave in the ends. And I'll start with the one that I just finished with. And cut the yarn. I made the two arms and this is what they look like. So we're going to go to the next thing, which is attaching the zipper. So I'll start by attaching the zipper to the cloth using pins, and then after that I'm going to sew the zipper to the cloth. This is what your work should look like at this point. So next you're going to sew the zipper onto the cloth. I'll be sewing on the wrong side because I don't want the thread I'll be using to be seen on the right side. For attaching the zipper, I'm using a sewing needle and a sewing thread. When sewing, ensure that your needle doesn't appear on the right side. I finished one side, so do the same thing on the other side. Once you're done with the zip, the top is done, and this is what it looks like. I felt like the V-shape was too plain, so I added chains on both sides of the V-shape and then tied it. And this is the final look.